guys, TJ here. I'm signing back on to BioShock 2. So, we're still in Sinclair's old hotel. I have no doubt things are just gonna get worse. Ammo, thank you. Should use all the ammo.
I know it's wrong to feel so fine right now, but I can't seem to quit this grin. Dr. Lamb came to tell me that Ryan's finally gonna lock her up. It's gonna gut the believers, and I should feel the same. But Sophia remembered that I was barren. And she asked me to take care of her baby while she's gone. Baby Eleanor Lamb. Gorgeous, clever little girl. I have a child now, and it's gonna put the whole world on right.
Sure. Keep telling yourself that. Weird. I'm hearing a big daddy. And maybe it's just the one that's just kind of wandering around. I did decide not to bother that one. Motherfucker. Pretended to be dead. No, I just gotta remember that is there. Got the Rapture Blues. Call Dr. Lamb. What do you see ahead? Dr. Lamb can... Dr. Lamb fucked things up worse than...
Now Gracie was on the top floor. Get on up there and persuade her to give you that override key.
By persuade? Do you happen to mean kill? Because I feel like that's how it's gonna go. I got turned around. Motherfucker. My safe. Mine. Kind of smoking, but you should be okay for just a little longer. Nice try. Better safe than sorry. They're showing that they, know how to fake being dead.
The baby snatcher's headed up into the hotel, family. He wants me so he can get to Eleanor. Tin Daddy feels no guilt. Tin Daddy feels no pain. But we are the family and we can teach him how.
I feel pain. I've been hurt plenty of times. You want to test that? Go ahead and shoot me. I'll growl in pain. Thank you. Oh, good news. Okay, gonna go through.
Watching you hurt shouldn't give me such a lift, monster. But I'm not as clean.
1 second. Okay, I gotta.
Know the inside as the doctor. I'll take my joy where I can.
Reading drill.
Blood divides us, monster. It's blood that makes us strangers. But thanks to Dr. Lamb, we're all family now. one people, one cause. You can stop this heart, bleed this old body, but you cannot end the family. And as for you, Tid Daddy, you're dying alone.
Don't think so. Ow.
I'm a modest man, but my piecemeal needle scam's an outright masterpiece. Some slob shacked up here buys a box of syringe parts from me for twice what it's worth. He assembles them in his rat hole, and I buy back the finished product for a dime against the dollar that I'll get from Ryan. Profit coming, profit going. Old Andy rambles on about the great chain. I got people shelling out to pull it for me.
I'm not expecting this to be easy, like, at all. Usually taking a boss on isn't. And Gracie's probably not gonna just...
Andrew Ryan told me that in Rapture, it didn't matter where you came from. Bunk! Times got hard and all our old bigotries bubbled right back. Dr. Lamb showed us that down under the skin, down under the money, down under our very name, we are family.
You, might need to get a better family then. Didn't mean to do that, but... God, this place is big.
Thank you. paper effigies as secret badges for the faithful. The Morpho Caterpillar doesn't spin a cocoon. It just grows armor on the inside before the change. It is us. To wear a butterfly is to support Dr. Lamb and the family. Before long, Rapture will split wide and take wing. Imago is coming.
Imago? What is an imago? I guess we'll find out.
Gracie's room is just up ahead. Now, she's been sending all manner of unkindness your way, so I'm not particular as to how you take that key away from her, but she's old, and this grudge against you was based on a misunderstanding.
More like manipulation. There we go.
Sinclair a few bucks for a load of vials and needles, then it's evenings putting these syringes together while I listen to the radio. Sell them back to Sinclair twice the price. What a racket. A few pinpricks here and there is nothing to complain about. Gonna be back on top soon. Thank you, Mr. Sinclair. Sucker.
Sucker, huh? How many of these splicers, which one of these splicers are you? Oh boy, here we come.
We both died tonight, monster. I, because your kind has killing in its nature. And you, because there's no way the family will let you stroll out alive with that key.
Get more for your research book. Keen observer. Carry your analysis further than you ever thought possible. You know, when I do...
in a fight with a dog eater today. His name is Amir, and he was picking on a smaller boy. We called a truce when his nose went red, but Mom says I'm becoming a barbarian. So I said, Eleanor, eat dog now too. Barbarian. Happy. And Mom said, they only think they're happy because they're selfish and ignorant. Eleanor, think ignorant sound like fun?
Okay, I like this kid. Grace, this is only gonna end one way.
Empty house. Only an echo to my name. Eleanor. Baby, where are you? I turned my back and someone took you. It happened so quick. I'm not even a half mama to you, girl. I couldn't protect you. This poster of Dr. Lamb in my room is staring me down like it knows I'm ashamed. I've always been loyal to your real mother, Eleanor. Always trusted her with my secrets. But I lost you. What will the doctor think of me now?
Thank you. Hello? Miss Gracie!
I know what you're here for. Go on, take it. I won't have you touching me. Sure. Dr. Lamb trusted me to care for her child. And I tried. But baby Eleanor disappeared. And then one day, I see her walking with you, looking wrong. And when I tried to hold her, you knocked me down. Broke my jaw. So I'm ready, baby snatcher. Come on in and finish the job.
Your call, friend. Gracie's unarmed, for what it's worth.
I got nothing against you. I'm just... Okay, bye.
To hell with you then. Go on.
You're a bigger man than I am, Chief. Maybe next time she'll think twice about pointing fingers before all the facts are in. Now, let's be on our way. Eleanor's waiting.
You had me under a gun, yet you just walk away. No monster alive turns the other cheek. No monster does that. A thinking man does that. I know that Dr. Lamb is no liar, but she's got to be wrong about you. Doesn't seem right now, letting you walk into that bushwhack waiting outside. I can't call off the family, but I can whisper a bit and improve your odds. These whirlybirds are custom jobs by an old friend. I'm afraid this is all I can do for now.
Hey, it works. Appreciate it. Thanks, Gracie. I got a few rivets to spare. Oh, wait, that's not a friend.
My lantern's lit. I'll find you. I inherited all of this.
Oh no.
survival of the fittest. That's the rule in the drop. The only rule. These numbskulls can't see the potential in leftover traces of sports boost. Armored shell. Tonics for increasing muscle mass and density. Oh, but I see the king of the jungle. First field trial of my new formula. Subject, Hartwig Leo. Right. Here goes.
Well, I think we just heard someone turn into one of those brutes.
Well, sir, I don't know what to call you now. You've done more than just spare my life. You've opened my eyes. I need to put a few questions to Dr. Lamb.
Don't expect her to answer truthfully.
By sparing grace, do you seek to gain my trust? A feeble ruse. Your crocodile tears may poison her with doubt, but I am not so easy a mark.
Oh, don't worry. I got a few bullets for your face.
Just take that override key and slot it into the control box in the ticket booth there. That'll open the gates.
Let's get out of here. Moving right along. Hey, Sinclair, you might want to hold your breath. We're going under again.
Kid, come on, wake up now. There you are. I thought you rode that torpedo into the great hereafter. I'm in Dionysus Park now. Train cars are shambles, leaking air. Whole damn place is flooded and sealed. But there's a pumping station back there on Siren Alley, and I believe you could jerry-rig it to drain the park out. That'd let you stroll right inside. Get to those pumps and hurry.
So, you're here.
The park is sealed, Chief. You aren't getting in there just yet. But if you get down to that pumping station in Siren Alley and drain the place out, this airlock will let you in.
Oh, I found Adam just lying around. Cool.
I see Father Wales has parted you from your craft, and yet you cling to life. Congratulations.
I'm just stubborn
today,
that way.
Today, Delta, you meet a man who has no fear of death, and for Eleanor, he would burn with a smile.
Here we are, Siren Alley.
Look at this rusty piece of crap! Show him what we got, boys.
Gonna bring you home as a trophy.
You're calling me a rusty piece of crap? Sure. Mm-hmm. I'm the rusty piece of crap. Well, that's where I'm going to end the episode. We got three sisters in this level. Oh boy. I need another big sister by the end of it. Either way, we'll continue this in the next one. Till then, I'm signing off. Bye-bye.